Hey guys, it's Neil again with Big League Tips, and today we're going to talk about the slide step, or a version of the slide step from the stretch. And a lot of this kind of has to do with other factors of the game, maybe your age, how old you are, how far the bases are based upon your league, and also based on the catcher, on how good his pop time is, or how well he can kind of throw guys out down to second base or even third base. So I'll kind of give you some basics about the slide step, and at the end, we'd love to kind of hear some feedback or maybe some different versions of the slide step that makes you feel comfortable still throwing the pitch and executing it. And that's the main part about the slide step, is making sure that you control the runner at first and then still making sure that you also execute your pitch if you don't pick off. So whenever we come set like this, I see a lot of younger kids want to come set very, very, very close together. And that's technically not a bad thing, but we may be a little bit slower going to home if we do have our feet together, because we would have to take our foot, our leg, all the way up and down to get any momentum behind, okay? So what I do is teach a lot of my younger guys and middle schoolers and high schoolers, whenever we come set, to almost be in almost like a hitter stance, but maybe just a little bit more narrow. So whenever we're come up acting like we're hitting like this, we would almost come set with that back knee bent just a little bit like this, to where we can actually be very powerful with our stance. Our back leg is already activated, but we can still do a slide step and still have a lot of power behind that. If you are a taller, lankier pitcher that has a lot of arm whip coming through, those guys can actually be narrow and they still have a lot of weight coming down the mound, where they could still activate their back leg, still have enough time, and they get to home plate very, very quick. I'm 6 foot. Maybe at the upper levels, I'm considered a little bit shorter, so I needed to make sure that I still used a lot of my back leg and still came through very quick. So whenever I would get my sign, I would double set like this, and I would be this wide, to after I actually checked the runner at first base, I would actually go knee to knee like this, which was very quick, to where I activated my back leg. I felt very strong, and I was still able to make the pitch at a lot less of a time than being in the windup like this, okay? That all kind of depends on the runner and the catcher. If the catcher is very, very good at his pop time, very good, sometimes you can kind of come up a little bit higher just to maybe figure out your timing. And the last thing with slide step, if you want to do the quicker one, up here, even if you want to be here and totally slide step and not go knee to knee, you need to make sure that you don't lose velocity and that you still execute your pitch, because as important as that guy is on first base, the hitter is probably more important, okay? I'd love to hear some more feedback on this. Go to our digital coaching to kind of talk about some more slide step stuff, and check out the rest of the website. All right, thanks guys.